Hello and welcome viewers and subscribers of AVG News. My name is Mxolisi, the son of Ncube, and I decided that I need to update you on a number of issues that are happening, especially political, regarding Zimbabweans that are based in South Africa. Well, what happened is that a few days ago, members of the Zimbabwean opposition, or let me say pro-democracy fighters, from Zimbabwe held a demonstration in South Africa where they made a number of demands to the South African government with regards to the situation back home, that is in Zimbabwe. You'll know that there is a lot that has been alleged against the government of President Emmerson Mnangagwa, especially in terms of human rights abuses. You'll know that there were people, about 79, including former Senator Jameson Timba, were arrested and detained. They've been detained since a few weeks before the SADC summit that happened in Zimbabwe, which saw Zimbabwe assume the chairmanship of the sub-regional body. So the protests were against the conferring of the chairmanship to Zimbabwe, especially to President Emmerson Mnangagwa. It was also against the continued alleged human rights abuses, especially the extrajudicial detention of the 79, including school-going children. So this morning we spoke to Trust Ndlovu, who is the SADC Citizens Democratic Society director, telling us about what exactly happened. He also explains their grievances and their preferred solutions about the ongoing political crisis in Zimbabwe.
Our main intention or objective was to hand over a petition with a list of issues that we asked the South African government for intervention, especially in Zimbabwe. We managed to picket and demonstrate it and highlighted our issues. So some of the issues that we did ask the South African government to intervene were as follows. The issue of human rights violation of Zimbabwe, you know, we have a lot of political prisoners, people who are disappearing, we have people who have been victimized, there's no democratic space, activists arrested, you know, civil society members, we have cited examples of them being imprisoned, tortured, butchered, some killed. No, so we're saying South African government is known for upholding human rights. It's known for constitutionalism, for democratic, for democracy. So we are saying, we are appealing to South African government to do what they have done in Israel-Palestine conflict. They went out and condemned openly. So we want the same extension to be done in Zimbabwe. They should just stand up and condemn violations of human rights. That's the first port of entry. The second thing is that as they have the capacity, they actually went as far as approaching the International Court of Justice to interdict Israel from killing Palestine. That's an violations of human rights in that taking place in that country. This is the same thing that is happening in Zimbabwe. We're saying South Africa should have the same zeal, same political will, same appetite, and use the energies, the same energy that they used in condemning Israel. They must condemn a ZANU-PF minority government at the moment. That brought us to the second issue, that this government of ZANU-PF, of Minister Mnangagwa, is not recognized by the people of Zimbabwe. Because the people of Zimbabwe, they know, they did not elect him. This government came out of a flawed process, and it is evidenced, documented empirically in the SADC-SIOM report. So our main second call was to say South Africa government, as the member states of SADC, come on board, use your influence to make sure that That SIOM report is exhausted, is discussed. It is a living document. It's a working document. That fact that Mr. Mnangagwa became the chair of SADC does not mean that that document was then automatically deleted. It wasn't. In fact, it was not even on the SADC summit agenda. So our call was to say that document should be looked at, and South Africa must use its influence to make sure that document is exhausted properly, which is a show for, which actually made it very clear that elections did not come out clearly, properly. Then, of course, the last thing which was very important was to call the South African government and appeal to South African government that during its operations on illegal immigrants, they must also exercise caution and restrain from excessive force. We've heard a lot of allegations around the country. I cited the issue of Dakar Fontaine in Springs, where illegal miners, what I call gold panners, were set alight, allegedly so, by soldiers, and were burned alive, some which resulted in their death. Some of them died. And because of that, we're calling upon the South African government to make sure that they restrain themselves from using excessive force. We got a lot other issues, other instances, other reports from different parts of the country. So those are the issues that we handed over. Those are some of the issues that we highlighted. We extensively talked about the issue of immigration, that it is an issue that we think must be dealt with using political solutions rather than legislation. Yes, the laws of this country must be respected, but without the political settlement where they are coming from, this issue will never be resolved.
That's the voice of Trust Ndlovu, the director of SADC Citizens Democratic Society, talking to us about what happened. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share it. Thank you.